Rigondeaux has used his strength and conditioning coach for the first time. He does look bigger up when he goes to the cards.
So we're set to go here with Rondo.
I don't think he'll be successful tonight with that punch. You know, throwing it so wild and so
experienced. Well, that number eight bout, that those
amateur fights in one night averaged that when he had to pull it out with a knockout win. Oh, big left hand by Rigondeaux, and Ramos is in trouble. He's down. He is in big trouble, and there is about a half minute left to go in this round.
I think that was a push in itself. He wants to
get knockdown with a push, but yeah, the punch did cause an effect.
Rigondeaux lands another straight left hand and pushes Ramos back again. Ramos against the ropes, in some trouble. Another left hand. They are raining down on Ramos. It's over, but lots of action. Let's see.
Looked like it was a left hand, to pretty high on the forehead. Now, clearly Ramos is in trouble. There's no punch to land there, and there was enough time between the left hand that hurt Ramos and Ramos going down that I don't think you should have called that a knockdown.
Really?
Was he hurt? Yes. But what? He missed that left hand.
Steve, I hate to say it, I'm going to agree with the other guys.
I stand alone and proud.
But you're proud. All right. We head in the rock. You'd love to see those guys move to the right so you can slow that. He fought a very defensive fight in what was supposed to be his coming out party, but he's not defensive tonight here in round two, although Rigondeaux bears it. Yes, indeed. I think he got the better of that, if I'm not mistaken.
Think about it. Rico Ramos told us he was nervous before his title fight.
Rangefinder Antonio made the point, it's not his strong weapon, which you think it would be more prevalent, but Rico Ramos defending the first time, down it. So Ismael Salas, a well-known issue for them, that they needed to have a trainer. He's the only one throwing punches, but not very many. Left and really set down to throw those hooks. Good left hand.
In fear of the counter punch, yeah, the same punch that hurt him in round one. But he has to let that go and fight.
The right hand. That'll keep him in place.
Yeah, so we're headed to rested the first time. He's had a very
before round. And Rigondeaux
in this water anytime soon.
We head into round number six, and the words of Ismael Salas might not sound like going into the four-corner offense after
the knockdown. But here comes part two of the equation.
Rigondeaux, and a lot is at stake. You know, when he fought victim Ricardo Cordoba, he was roundly criticized, and maybe some thought more so.
Rabbit punch.
Yeah, yeah. And a left eye of Ramos. He's, oh, got a problem, and now here comes Rigondeaux. And there goes Rico Ramos from a left to the body. And that one was very legal.
Six, seven, eight, nine.
It is over. Guillermo Rigondeaux with a body shot ends this fight and ends the one fight reign of Rico Ramos in the 122-pound division. And that is a happy Team Rigondeaux as they see their man in his ninth professional fight win a world title.
He did what he had to do, but I just feel like when I look at Rico Ramos and his ability to do what he needed to do tonight, it was just a young fighter way in over his head, became champion too soon, and where you go when you're champion, you have to fight the top-notch competitors. There's nowhere to go but up.
And Rigondeaux was a mandatory champion, which is the key. But we like that. We want to see people...